In a nutshell, some scientists, have come to believe that carbon dioxide, which exists naturally in the world and which humans contribute to through their industrial processes, is responsible for heating the planet. And so this whole movement began as global warming, but actually it didn't. It actually began as global cooling. Back in the 70s, some scientists looked at the trend and anticipated that back then mankind was approaching global cooling, a new ice age. And a group of them sent a letter to the president at the time in the United States and said, "We are in imminent danger of cooling. We need to do something about it." Now, in reality, that was a natural cycle. And all of a sudden, things started to warm. And almost in a seamless way, the scientists then said, actually, the world is warming and we're responsible for it and we need to do something about it. So if you wind yourself back to the last decade of the last century, apart from there being a global warming spike, which is a natural thing, which is an El Nino spike, which was one of the largest that we've had, which you might say artificially raised temperatures above the norm. Apart from that, it seemed for that decade like the increase in carbon dioxide as measured by the Mauna Loa Observatory on Hawaii and world average temperatures were both going up in tandem. So scientists then latched onto this and said the one is the cause of the other. Now, in a way, you could have gone either way. You could have said the temperature is leading or causing the increase in carbon dioxide, or you could do the opposite and say the increase in carbon dioxide is causing the increase in the temperature. Well, they chose the latter. They claimed that carbon dioxide was the one that was causing the temperature rise. So what they're saying is there is a causal relationship between rising levels of carbon dioxide and rising temperatures. The one is the cause of the other. And they have wanted everybody to adopt that viewpoint, and they pressed it very, very hard. The only problem with that is that after that last decade, temperatures which had been going up all of a sudden were no longer following the carbon dioxide, but went wandering off all over the place. And so world average temperatures from around 1998, around about 2000, until today have shown no net warming. And in fact, in one year, around about 2007, all the supposed warming caused by industrial processes in the 20th century evaporated, just completely collapsed. And so that was the time the scientists changed the title of global warming to climate change. And since then, they've adopted what to many normal people seems amazing, which is that whether it warms or whether it cools, whether it's wetter or drier, whether it's windier or calmer, all of that is due to carbon dioxide. Now, there's the controversy. One group of scientists, supposedly a 97% consensus, except that's not true, say, yes, whatever is happening to our climate is being caused by carbon dioxide and especially human beings. And lots of other scientists are saying, well, hold on a minute, let's examine that more carefully and see if that's true. And there's your controversy. There's another thing about carbon dioxide. It's almost that it is characterized as a poison. There's something evil and horrible about it because it's making the earth warm. Not just warm, but risk cooking, getting hot and killing all of us. But in reality, it's not. Carbon dioxide is one of these trace gases. Certainly, it does have a warming effect, no question about that. But it's a lot less than the scientists imagine in their global warming models. And it's not a poison. It's a plant food. And we all know that. Without carbon dioxide, then, photosynthesis falls apart. The higher it is, the better plants and trees grow. And the proof of that is that by using satellites, they've actually observed a greening of the Earth over this period when carbon dioxide has been going up.
Subscribe and click the notification bell to receive updates about new content. Visit tomorrowsworld.org for more articles, telecasts, and booklets.